Management of plan implementation. First, how do you manage your plan implementation? The first thing is to do planning the plan implementation. The first thing is for you to plan the implementation procedure. Once a plan has been put in place and the implementation plan is not planned, then it might not likely to achieve the goal and the purpose. So there are structures you need to fall through to plan the implementation. Now going through, remember you need to look at the resources available, look at the manpower that will be required that will enable you to implement such plan and the policies that are in place. Once you are able to get this with the finance, then you are sure that the planning will succeed. Now we look at the dimensions. First, we look at the dimensions influencing the plan of the plan implementation. Because from the dimension that may be affecting it, we could look at the cultural, social, economic, technology, and politics that could be part of the dimensions that will be affecting it. Now, you look at the planning requirements. What are the requirements that are needed in planning? Now, in this area, you look at the leadership and management commitment. You look at the competencies of planners. You look at the timing. You look at the finance. You look at the information and the organizational climate. These are what you will take off when you are planning the implementation plan. You have to look at the leadership and the commitment of that leadership, because if they are not committed to it, the plan will fail. And you look at the competencies of the planner. If they are not competent, again, the plan will fail. The timing, the finance, and the formation organization. Now, we have to look at the planning techniques. What technique was used? There are different techniques that are available to us. For example, you have management by objective, MBO. You have planning, evaluation, and review technique, PET. You have DEFI management technique. You have planning, programming, and budgeting system. You have zero-based budgeting. You have convergence technique, simulation technique, normal group techniques. You have forecasting and trend analysis method. You have modeling. You have force street technique. You have management information system, advocate team process, and scenario technique. There are so many of them. So, but however, you see that in each of the techniques you are using, you need to choose a good one. Which out of the techniques are you using? And it's not in all situations, all techniques may fit. The type of plan you are carrying out may determine the type of techniques that you need to use. So you need to come up with the techniques that is most fit. For example, let's look at the DEFI management technique. In the DEFI management technique, you may want to come up with manpower, and you need to give some questionnaire to some group of managers to fill for you to find out the type of education they will need from their staff and so on. So when you fill, you return it back again until at the end, you are having a zero. What you are looking out for is now at the 0 point of it. The next thing we need to look at is the monitoring during implementation. This is very, very key. What do you monitor during implementation? The needs for monitoring. You have to spell it out. Why do I want to monitor? Because that will help you to come up with the needs why you want to monitor. Now, review process, then evaluating the level of implementation. Finally, we'll have to come up with policy and assessment. You now have to come up with a policy and assessment. You have done your monitoring, you have done the implementation, monitoring during the implementation by looking at the need, you have looked at the review, you have evaluated the level of implementation. Now, out of the level of implementation, you cannot derive your policy plan assessment. So from the policy plan assessment, your policy can then emanate. This is how you need to plan the implementation plan.